My name is Maria and I'm the president of Waterford Lions Club for the year 2020-2021. The Christmas Hamper Appeal is an initiative of Waterford Lions Club. It has supported the St Vincent de Paul in Waterford for more than 30 years, and this year, more than ever, the need has never been greater. The club has over 30 members, and for the appeal, every member, their family and friends come together to make this very important event happen. As you can appreciate, due to COVID-19, we cannot do the normal fundraising events which we traditionally do. In particular, bucket collection, coffee mornings, and of course the collection at supermarkets. The highlight of the appeal for many people is the carol concert held in the cathedral every Christmas, and this year it's going to be different, and Kevin will tell you all about it later. To this end, on behalf of the Lions Club, I would ask everyone listening to donate as much as you can, no matter how small, as every cent counts. And the number for this is at the end of the screen. You can also go to Waterford Lions Club Facebook page where you can access the site. I wish to thank my fellow Lions, the people of Waterford and the surrounding areas, and everyone who has helped in this process. I want to especially thank Kevin, who has selflessly put the whole event together. We are forever grateful for his support over the years. I would also like to thank JP O'Donoghue and Company solicitors, accountants and auditors, who are our main sponsor of the concert. Frontline Audio Vision, Visual, and Waterford in Your Pocket. Finally, I want to thank WLR for supporting the Lions Club with the 2020 Christmas Hamper Appeal. Again, please donate as much as you can. Thank you very much.
It's the second Saturday before Christmas at 4 p.m. in the afternoon, and I'm here in the Cathedral of the Most Holy Trinity, Baron Strand Street, Waterford. Normally at this time, I'm surrounded by hundreds of people as instrumentalists, choristers and audience members come together for a concert which marks the start of Christmas in Waterford for so many people. Behind the scenes, we would normally have Frankie King of Frontline Audio Visual with his crew of stage builders and engineers. Members of the Lions Club would be helping people to their seats, and voluntary medical services would be on hand in case of any emergency. Checking the script in the sacristy would be Damien Tiernan or some other representative from WLR FM. This year is different. It's just myself and Frankie with cameraman Paul Dower from Waterford in Your Pocket. In the age-honoured tradition of show business, however, the show must go on. I know the choirs can't rehearse and the orchestra cannot come together, but we do have recordings from previous years that will help you get into the Christmas spirit. The purpose of the concert every year is to raise funds for the Lions Club Christmas Hamper Appeal, and this year we need funds more than ever. At the bottom of your screen are the details of how you can donate to the cause. The great news this year is that you can donate from anywhere in the world. For those of you listening on WLR FM on Christmas Day, I say welcome. For many, myself included, family members have not been able to come home this year. Hopefully, we can bring to them some sounds of home on a day that is so special to Waterford families all over the world. Every good concert needs a good overture, and when it comes to Christmas overtures, there are none better than Leroy Anderson's A Christmas Festival. This performance comes from the 2019 concert with video footage courtesy of Waterford in Your Pocket. Leading the orchestra is Emer Heaney. Thank you. There are only two carols that have been heard in every Waterford Lions Club Christmas concert, and O Come All Ye Faithful is one of them. Last year saw us complete 30 years of the event, and to help us celebrate that occasion, a fanfare ensemble from the Irish Defence Forces, 1 Brigade Army Band Collins Barracks, Cork, were in attendance. With 3 Waterford men amongst them, their fanfare ensemble introduced our first carol of the day. Over the years, there have been several different presenters of the Lions Club Christmas concert. But the longest serving presenter was WLR's Billy McCarthy. One of the difficulties caused by Billy was his inability to be quiet when he wasn't supposed to be singing. In 2010, I finally gave in and gave Billy his own song to sing. He was so excited at the prospect that he became a little inventive when it came to the lyrics. But being the pro that he was, he recovered well. Singing Mel Torme's and Bob Wells' classic, The Christmas Song, also known as Chestnuts Roasting on an Open Fire, here is Billy McCarthy from 2010.
Jack Frost nipping at your nose. Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe make the season. Lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh, and every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeers really know how to fly. And so I'm offering a simple phrase to kids from 20 to 92. It's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to
At this point in proceedings, I'd like to say a very special word of thanks to Father Cullinan and to the staff here at the Cathedral of the Most Holy Trinity, Barnstrand Street, Waterford. Every year they allow us to come in and take over the cathedral for the day of the concert. This year, although there's no concert, we are again taking over their cathedral for doing these introductions. Hopefully it gives you an opportunity to see parts of the cathedral that you've not seen before. The normal programme for the Lions Club concert involves solo appearances by some of the participating choirs. If I was to include a piece from all of the participating choirs over the years, we would be here until next year. Rather than featuring some choirs and leaving others out, I've decided to stick to pieces either performed by the full choir or by the orchestra. And that's where we're going now, as the orchestra plays Frosty the Snowman from the 2016 performance. Led by Emer Heaney, here is the Hamper Appeal Orchestra. A quick reminder to you all to donate as much as you can afford to the Hamper Appeal. Details of how to contribute are on the bottom of your screen. People are often surprised to hear how this event is put together. Though the choirs rehearse for their own Christmas events through October and November, the choir the audience see on the Hamper Appeal stage only comes together at 12 noon on the day of the concert. The orchestra only comes together 1 hour earlier. The maximum we can hope for, therefore, is a total of 3 hours rehearsal. In fact, none of the preparations can begin until after morning mass, and everything has to be back in place before the evening mass. This takes an army of people, all of whom go to make this event what it has become. Time restrictions also mean that microphone positions are placed on a best guess basis, and we do what we can afterwards to mix the sound as well as possible. In a nutshell, I consider a successful Hamper Appeal concert to be a minor miracle. And yet, year after year, it works. 2010 is one of the few years for which we have video footage, and from that year is our performance of The First Noel.
Thank you.
I don't remember the year that I found an online orchestral sheet music retailer, but I was delighted to do so. It meant that we got some wonderful compilation pieces, such as There's Christmas in the Air. Some weeks ago, Waterford in Your Pocket asked Waterford people abroad to send in images with Christmas greetings to their folks at home. Keep your eyes peeled, as you might see some familiar faces while the Hamper Appeal Orchestra with leader Emer Heaney plays Carl Stroman's There's Christmas in the Air from the 2019 concert.
Thank you.
2016 was a difficult year for all involved in the Lions Club Christmas concert, as it was only a month earlier that Billy McCarthy died. I can clearly remember getting a telephone call from WLR preparing me for the dreadful news. In a tribute to Billy, Glenn Murphy sang Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas that year. Glenn was grateful to Billy for the support shown as Glenn built his career. Watch closely at the end of this clip, because having finished singing, Glenn looks heavenwards in an acknowledgement to his friend in a silent word of thanks.
Magnificent for you, Billy. And well done to the international sensation we're very proud to call our own, Glenn Murphy.
Normally, at this time in proceedings, I hand over to the president of the Lions Club as they ascend the pulpit to ask you to contribute to the Hamper appeal. This year, it's my turn. Details of how to contribute are at the bottom of your screen. I love Christmas time, and to the astonishment of some, I still believe in Santa. That might come as a surprise, but it's true. I don't necessarily mean the man in the big red suit, the long white beard. Sometimes Santa works undercover, dressed in medical scrubs and masked up with personal protection equipment. Sometimes Santa is in civvies and simply smiles and waves at someone that needs a smile or a reassuring gesture. Santa can even go in disguise as a teacher who manages to connect with a student and in the process help them to blossom and achieve their potential. Today, Santa can be the person that looks at the bottom of the screen and donates to this worthy charity. Go on, be a Santa today. Donate to someone you don't know. Share some of your Christmas so that someone else can have a Christmas of their own. Details of how to donate are at the bottom of your screen. In any of the lists of best loved carols, O Holy Night is always close to the top. We've performed this piece several times at the Lions Club concert, but I've never really been happy with the orchestration. The orchestral arrangement never really worked for me. On two separate occasions, I actually reorchestrated the piece, but I still wasn't happy. For the 30th concert last year, I was determined to create an arrangement with which I would be happy. Having heard a version online, I had some new ideas to play with, and I was finally pleased with the result. We're blessed in Waterford to have one of Ireland's finest sopranos, Róisín O'Grady. From the 2019 concert, here is Róisín with the Mast Choir and the Hamper Appeal Orchestra in Adolph Adams' O Holy Night.
Thank you.
Silent Night is a carol that has instant international recognition. The simplicity of the piece makes it popular with adults and children alike. In 2008, we celebrated this carol by using this same simple guitar accompaniment with which it was originally performed. The guitarist was Joe Whelan. With thanks to John Power and others for the images from past concert, here is Silent Night. Following last year's event, I wondered how we were going to be able to follow what had been a tremendous celebration of 30 years. Little did I know that we'd have to settle for something so very, very different to what we had known for three decades. By August, it was obvious that the event could not go on in its usual format. Instead, we sent out the call for singers and instrumentalists with or without connections to Waterford to help us in a virtual Hark the Herald Angels Sing. When the recordings came in from all over the world, they were mixed together by Kevin O Carroll, who is a sound engineer now living in Cardiff and who for many years helped her dad, setting out chairs, collecting music, doing what was needed to make the miracle of the Lions Club work yet again, before sitting down to play clarinet in the orchestra. Thank you, Kweva, for putting this final piece together. My last word of thanks must go to Frankie King of Frontline Audiovisual and Paul Dower of Waterford In Your Pocket. Paul, until now, has been a subtle partner in the project, but without whose help this year, it would not have been possible. Thank you, Paul. And may I wish you all a happy Christmas, and I look forward to seeing you here in the Cathedral of the Most Holy Trinity, Baron Strand Street, Waterford, on December 11th, 2021, at 4 p.m. in the afternoon. I leave you with a virtual performance of Hark the Herald Angels Sing. Stay safe, and don't forget to be someone's Santa today.